Wait, it's the kids next door?
Pops taught me the game. I made my own adjustment.
What's going on, YouTube, social media world? It's your boy Anonymous, based in on biggity biggity back with a new reaction video. This time I got another request. Go ahead and give a shout out to the person that gave me the request. Let's go ahead and get into it, man. So if you're new to the channel, go ahead and give this video a like, share with a couple of your friends. Make sure you follow me on all my social media sites. And if you got something specific, go ahead and drop it in that comment section. So we are back with a new artist that I never heard of before, and he goes by the name of Money Boy Mike, and this track is called Keeping It Real. All right, let's get it.
Wait, it's the kids next door?
I like that sample.
Pops taught me the game. I made my own adjustments. I can take no loss. It's either all or none. Bitches steady bugging me. I must need some office something. All the haters that came in my life, I thank you all for coming. Mac in the book bag. Don't make me call my cousin. If that nigga pull up, ain't no talking. It's just all bustin'. Nigga, I've been ballin' before. Roddy Rich and DJ Mustard. Too much clothes in my closet. Everything is cluttered. Guns shooting movies. Call my shit a blockbuster. Crazy house about my day one. Niggas, I cannot trust them. Her, she was fucking with the broke. I could not love her, but fuck it. If I run into her friend, then I might fuck her. It's crazy how the game go. Hell is why I can't go. Remember all them days, po. Now when you can't go. They look at my fit and they say, damn, how much you pay for. Can't wait till this bullshit over when I'm getting way more. Yeah, everything I spit is facts. I'm just keeping it real. Paper overlapping like when TJ rapping. I just hopped on that one beat and started spazzing. Never sat on the bench, I'm calling plays like Madden. I hate I fell out with my nigga, me and him still clashing. Told her if it ain't meant for us, it'll never happen. Always putting on the road, I ain't know you acting. Niggas get Rico by their homie, should've stopped that capping. Who gon' be there with you when your casket, I'm just asking. I seen them niggas lacking, they was just on IG flashing. I know some broken ratchets, they about to let them have it. I used to be that young nigga, ooh, I need that young nigga. Me and Alex at the center, used to keep that weapon with us, hit our first lick. That nigga went and bought some Gucci slippers, we was 15. We was sipping lean, he smoking swishes, I was low with it. He was on the gram just taking pictures, now my nigga gone. Heard me that he drowned up in that river. Yeah, everything I spit is facts, I'm just keeping it real. Everything I speak is facts, I'm just keeping it real.
All right, okay, man. Shout out to Money Boy Mike for coming through with his track called Keeping It Real. All right, so let's go ahead and get into the reaction, man. Okay, so first impressions of me hearing this for the first time. I gotta say, you actually got a little something, man. You got a long way to go and you got a lot of work to do, but I can tell that your heart's in the right place. So, as far as this track goes, the beat selection, I'm going to start with the beat. The beat selection is good. And the reason I say that is because with a beat like this, if it was slower, I could picture Drake doing a track with that or Rick Ross doing a track with that or maybe both of them together and maybe Meek Mill on that beat. So the beat selection is an industry type of beat. If you had to slow it down, threw in, you know, like a different 808 pattern that came in harder with the kicks and used a different snare instead of a rim shot, that would have been good. You would have been a lot more solid with it. Okay, so Your song itself is good. The subject matter is good. I understand the message that you're trying to get across. I get that. But here's the thing. The problem with this is that I can clearly tell that this is a rough draft, because when I'm listening to the vocals all the way through, I can hear that extra air, that background air from when you were editing, or whoever was editing, whoever your engineer is. I can hear where they actually chop the pieces off, and then you hear that air cut off. You can actually hear it when the vocal, like when there's space in between you saying something on the track, you can hear that air cut off. So that tells me right then and there that you recorded this in a room or something that had too much space in it, to where there was a lot of background air and you didn't use any plugins to drown that out. And what you should have done, whoever your engineer is, this is what they should have done. If you're going to cut those, if you're going to cut the front end and the back end of the audio off like that, to kind of delete that dead air, what you needed to do is you need to put a fader on the front and then put a fader on the end and try to get it as close to the very beginning of the vocal and the very end of the vocal as possible. Cut that all the way and then put a tiny fader on the front and the back. A little bit of engineering techniques for y'all. Because I use Pro Tools. I'm on Pro Tools. But you know what I'm talking about for the engineers out there. So that's what you should have done. And if you don't know how to do that, if you're savvy with plugins, then you could have used a plugin called the NS1 Noise Suppressor. Put it on about 40. Anything above 40, your audio is gonna sound muffled. 40, it'll do you a great amount of justice, and it takes out that background air to where you'll have some good solid vocals. There's a lot of work that needed to be done on those vocals, man. I can clearly tell when I was listening to it that it was a rough draft. The beat sounded like it was put together well, but the problem is that the vocals were not engineered correctly to where it sounds like it's part of the beat, or that it kind of, you know, flows steady with the beat. Because the way you want to do it, this is how it's supposed to be. So when you're engineering, you have to engineer the vocals in a way to where the vocals will sit right here and the beat kind of makes a shape around it, to where the vocals are front and center, and then you have all the instrumentation around it. Like if you go to a concert and you see that the performer is front and center and then they have a live band or something, the band is always around or somewhere in the back of the performer. So the way it's set up, when you're sitting there watching, you have the vocals coming at you front and center, and then you have the instruments spreading out like this, to where you have the vocals in the center and all the instrumentation is surrounding it to provide you that 3D listening experience. So that's how you have to engineer the vocals within the song and within the beat as well. See, when I engineer music, I create my beats in a way to where you can get that full listening experience. So then when I take that over to Pro Tools and I lay down some vocals or whatever, I'm doing all of my chops and my edits, throwing that NS1 noise suppressor, and then I throw on the vocal rider too to make sure that everything is balanced out, along with me tweaking the levels manually. But I want to make sure that everything can be heard evenly. I make sure I adjust my ad-libs properly, my background vocals properly, and I make sure that my verses and everything sound on point. And I put faders on the fronts and the ends, and I make sure I get rid of that dead air, so that way I have good quality vocals on the first session. So then once I do that, everything is blended together. Then I create a mastering session where I do all my plugins and I do all my final touch-ups, where I throw my reverb on there. I throw my like 3 or 4 compressors on there. CLA-76, BF, I want to say it's BF-76. I throw on a DL-3. And then I use something else too. I just can't think of it off the top of my head, but I throw on an air reverb. Sometimes I'll use Greg Wells Voice Centric, but a lot of times I'll use the S1 Stereo Imager, and then I always make sure that I use the Air Kill, the Advanced Instrument Research Air Kill. Like there's a lot of things that I do to make sure that my vocals come out nice and clean. from an engineering standpoint, from the recording all the way to me applying my plugins and making sure that everything comes out the way it's supposed to where I can adjust everything with the threshold on the compressor, on all my compression. I make sure that my input is lower. I always make sure that my input is lower than my output. I always make sure that my attack is all the way up, and then I kind of fluctuate with the release. Cause I don't put the release and the attack the same. I mean, I know it sounds technical for all the people that don't understand the ins and outs of how music works and how to put it together. But for the engineers, you guys know what I'm talking about. It makes a lot of sense. But anyway, when it comes to you recording your vocals, bro, you're not doing a bad job. You got it. The thing is, whoever you're working with on this engineering, they need to get with you and really sit you down and walk you through how this works, so that way you're not just recording it one time and saying, all right, let's go ahead and bounce it and then let's send it out. Because you can clearly tell this is a rough draft. Now, I know you might be kind of new to it, because I can tell that you're kind of new to the recording and putting music out. And, you know, it's good that you're getting your feet wet with it. But, however, if you want more plays, and if you want more exposure, and if you want people to take your music seriously, you have to put more time and effort into actually crafting the music and creating works of art. And now I'm going to leave it there. So with that being said, that's pretty much my reaction, man. So if you like the video, go ahead and give it a like. Share it with a couple of your friends. Make sure you follow me on all my social media sites. And if you got something specific, go ahead and drop it in that comment section, man. It's your boy Anonymous Bass. Peace.
I can take no loss, nah. It's either all or none. Bitches steady bugging me, I must need some off of something. All the haters that came in my life, I thank you all for coming. Mac in the book bag. Don't make me call my cousin. If that nigga pull up, ain't no talking, it's just all bustin'. Nigga, I been ballin' before Roddy Rich and DJ Mustard. Too much clothes in my closet, everything is cluttered. Guns shootin' movies, call my shit a blockbuster. Crazy house about my day one, niggas, I cannot trust them. Her, she was fucking with the broke. I could not love her, but fuck it. If I run into her friend, then I might fuck her. It's crazy how the game go. Hell is where I can't go. Remember all them days po. Now where you can't go. They look at my fit and they say, damn, how much you pay for. Can't wait till this bullshit over when I'm getting way more. Yeah, everything I spit is facts. I'm just keeping it real.